向かってくるのか、逃げずにこのディオに近づいてくるのか。せっかく祖父のジョセフが私のザワールドの正体を試験終了チャイム直前まで問題を解いている受験生のような必死こいた気分で教えてくれたというのに。
近づかなきゃてめえをぶちのめせないんでな。
ほうほう。では
there's nothing shaking come this here July, I'm gonna roll myself up in a big ball and die.
Before the video begins, is this thing on? Before the video begins, I have very tragic news for all of you. According to YouTube statistics, 95% of you are not subscribed. What the fuck? Okay, last time we were at 80% not subscribed. And I was thinking, okay, that's just gonna get better. But all it did was go up more. I know these times are hard. Everybody is short on money. Not everybody can subscribe to things. That's why I'm going to give you a deal. What if I told you that for a limited time, all subscriptions are free. And on top of that, I won't even fine you if you unsubscribe. That means you can subscribe for free and unsubscribe for free. Limited time, guys. Take advantage of this while you can. I'm going to make up a bullshit number real quick. 95% of you are not subscribed. That's about 3.7 billion of you. Hey guys, what the fuck? I mean, I don't have a family to feed. They're doing pretty fine on their own. But if I did have a family to feed, would you subscribe? You bet your ass you would, so subscribe. Please. I see you there. I see you. Yeah, I'm looking right at you. Actually, I'm looking down at your taskbar right now. I don't see that subscribe button gray. It's still red. I think you need to press that. And maybe turn on post notifications. And like all my videos. And share it. And whatever other weird thing you can think of to my video. What the fuck? I don't think this is on. You know, I actually bought this microphone stand because on Amazon it says universal size, meaning that this part right here can fit any microphone you want. Guaranteed, no questions asked. And I'll be the judge of that. I mean, it sets up easy enough. You see there, that just doesn't fit. Like, you really just can't get good products anymore. That'll work. Well, y'all thought it was over. After two videos combining over 12,000 views, you would think I'd got my point across and I wouldn't have to make another video. Wrong. A lot of you have been asking for another video of me destroying this website, so I thought maybe I'll make another one. And this time, I've got stuff to say. So once again, Edgenuity, you're up the bat. I think it well speaks for itself when I say it. People don't like this program. Entire articles written about this site's ineptitude to bring even the slightest of their promises to life has made revolt from students, teachers, and people all over. So why do schools still use this site?
that's still a mystery to me. And it's not like this is some small site anymore. Like, Edgenuity is one of the biggest online learning sites there is. And they still have the same broken user interface, terrible customer service, and the same terrible teachers that seem like they've been kidnapped and forced to teach. Doesn't that just sound so exciting? Where learning clicks is their slogan, but it's only true if learning is the name of the gun that you're using to shoot yourself, because death is a preferable alternative to Edgenuity. And goddamn, it's been 4 months since my last video on this site, and your servers are still absolute fuckass. You log in, you do your assignments, you get done with it just to learn that the servers have been down the whole time, so nothing saved. It's like GTA Online, you get that prompt at the bottom left of your screen that says the Rockstar services are down, and none of your progress is going to be saved. But in this case, at least GTA gives you a prompt that says that. Edgenuity is just like, oh, you took a unit test? And you got 100? Good job, champ! Go fuck yourself, we didn't save any of that. It's a series of mental gymnastics just to figure out if what you're doing even counts, because you don't even know if the server is up or not. Okay, the teachers are shit, the user interface makes you want to barf, but like, the servers don't work? Go fuck you. You remember when I said the customer service was shit? I wasn't kidding. I know I take a huge shit on Windstream's customer service, but like, at least they pick up the phone. This past week I called Edgenuity because I needed some help because, again, their servers went down. And I waited, I'm not even kidding, 10 minutes for someone to pick up. And spoiler alert, they didn't pick up. And like, I called the next day and they did pick up after 2 minutes, which is blistering speeds, by the way. And I'm like, finally, I can get some help around here. I can finish that college assignment I had so I can pass this class and get a good grade and be able to do... I paused. You wanna know why I paused? Take a guess. You think it's because some Indian guy who barely speaks English picked up the phone? You racist, you're right. That's right, a man named Rajim, don't ask me how to spell that, picked up the phone and spoke something that I can only assume to be alien language because I know it's not practiced on Earth. I would have had a better time like speaking to a Sam Bushman tribal person. Their fucking language is clicking.
Oh, really now? You don't say. That actually makes a lot of sense. Thank you. Well, how about it? I got it.
Like, what the fuck? I promise I'm not being racist. It's just literally, I didn't know this guy was speaking. Are we just not gonna talk about the teachers? The teachers kinda remind me of my college professor in a way. My college teacher was an ex-electrician for robots and a glass company, but he was laid off because of COVID, so he just kinda came over to the college voluntarily to teach to us. And like, the Edgenuity teachers seem like that too. New to this, they speak softly, they're kind of a little bit nervous, they're not really sure if they wanna be there. No, wait, no. These people are certified teachers, meaning some fucking university somewhere, God help them, gave them a teaching license and said, hey, you can go teach people now, just try not to care too much. You would think they had been like kidnapped and held at gunpoint, like, hey, you're gonna teach Mr. Beard, you're gonna tell them everything about circles and whatnot, and you're gonna do it. And they're like, circles are a shape, they're round. You can put things in circles. They lack creativity, that pizzazz, that little flair that every other teacher in real life has, you know? It's just like they're reading from a textbook, and that textbook also happens to have no personality. My dog could form a more interesting lesson than that. And I would only give him 4 minutes to do it, and it would be kick-ass. All he would do is lick his fucking balls. And the videos are just so shit, man. You think my content is low budget? An Edgenuity video looks like they went to a root cellar and pulled out some sort of 1980s movie camera and gave them a fucking flip-flop for a mic and say, hey, go ahead and film your fucking lesson on this, man. Like, it is genuinely headache-inducing just to hear these people talk. Or just to watch the video with how fucking grainy it is. It's like you're watching the fucking beach live stream. And where's Mr. Beard? What the fuck? My boy has been missing from my Edgenuity experience for so long. I need him. The last time I saw his beautiful, firm, silky beard was back when I did fucking ADAPT. Mr. Beard is the only one that can save us from 2020. He's like Jesus' brother, the second coming. He's great. We need Mr. Beard back. Yeah, I changed shirts. Shut up. You ever seen that TV show Everyone Hates Chris? I feel like Edgenuity needs a TV show like that, but it's just everyone absolutely abhors and hates and despises Edgenuity. That'd be a good show. For real though, I've never seen a comment that wasn't bribed that was talking good about Edgenuity. Every article I've seen or every comment I've seen has been just fucking dog shitting. Just taking an absolute fucking hammer to Edgenuity. Because people don't like it, you know? Teachers, children, schools, God. Everybody fucking hates this program. And it's still a fucking wonder to me that we still use it. When you look up Edgenuity on YouTube and my video comes up first, I mean, like, come on. That's pretty fucking bad. Not even their own YouTube channel could get their video first. Like, what the fuck? I really do think Everyone Hates Chris parody of Edgenuity would be pretty funny, though. Like, we just have that fucking CEO, whatever her fucking name is, like, as the main character. But instead of people just be like, Chris, it's just like someone takes a fucking shotgun to her face and fucking blows her fucking... I want to fucking kill that bitch. I want to talk to you on a personal level real quick. If you're watching this video, there's a good chance that you use Edgenuity or have ever used Edgenuity. So have you ever learned anything from it? My comment section for my last video was just nothing but comment after comment praising Brainly or talk about how little they fucking learned from it. So what even is the point of online teaching in a whole when everybody is just either cheating or just not paying attention to it? You know, everybody and their fucking mom and their mom's mom knows that nobody's fucking doing Edgenuity because they're learning. They're doing it for an easy grade. My school system gives people the choice to do online learning or in real life learning. And a lot of people chose online learning, not because they're scared of COVID. Nobody's fucking scared of COVID. Let me just tell you that right now. The only people that are afraid of COVID are fucking Karens in fucking Israel or something, all right? Listen, the people that are scared of COVID are not the students of schools. I'll tell you that much. They're just doing online learning because last semester, when they had to do it, they got a good fucking grade, I'll tell you that. I just really think the premise of online learning, especially for Edgenuity's case, where it's so easy to cheat. I mean, like, come on. If it was up to me, I would make it so IRL schooling would be a higher goal than online learning. So, like, colleges would look and say, well, this guy did get a 3.0 GPA, but that was online, so he may have been cheating. Let's just look at him again to make sure we're not getting fucking dogged here. Because I'm going to tell you this right now. Would you want a fucking brain surgeon that went to IRL college working on your brain or somebody that fucking maybe used Brainly online for the past couple months? Come on. Really? Do you want somebody fucking putting your house together and he just fucking learned all these fucking components and stuff from Brainly.com or like Quizlet? No, you don't want that. All right. And you wouldn't like it. Don't pretend you do. Don't play devil's advocate for online learning just because your kid or you're doing it. You know it's bad. We all know it's bad. You're cheating. We all fucking know you're cheating. Admit it. You're fucking cheating. Fucking admit it. I know you're cheating. At the end of the day, the user interface for Edgenuity definitely doesn't give any good points towards the system as a whole. I just don't understand why Edgenuity has to be so fucking brutal to you if you're behind in a class. I mean, it shows that you were in the red, and that's okay. I mean, that's a good indication that you're behind. But it also tells you how far you're behind and how long it's going to take to catch up. And maybe it even emails your teacher and says, hey, dumbass over here forgot to do his project today. I think maybe you should call his parents, maybe get him in a little bit of trouble. I would do that. I mean, I know one day, it's wrong usually, because I know one day I was fucking doing my project thing, right? And it said it was going to take an hour and a half for me to finish it. I got done within 20 minutes. I mean, that's still not good because 20 minutes on Edgenuity feels like 20 days. But that's still a whole lot faster than an hour and 30 minutes, Edgenuity. You're about to give me a fucking heart attack. There's no reward system on this site if you complete an assignment or complete a class even. It's just like... I'm sending you back to the home screen now. For sites like FunBrain and Classworks, they give you like badges, or in Classworks' case, they give you a little shield thing that tells you how good you do right there. And a good job, you finished it. Way to go, pal. You really did it. It doesn't fucking mean anything, but it makes me feel a whole lot better. And Edgenuity just takes themselves way too seriously for a site that nobody else is taking as seriously. It's like when the school whore shows up to the prom wearing a respectable gown. Like, bitch, we know what you are. Alright? Stop fucking fronting it. We know what you are. You suck. Literally. You suck a lot. You really suck. You're really good at Dyson, man. You're fucking... Yeah, why not do that? Edgenuity, for some unknown fucking reason, is only limited to laptops and computer desks. Do they really think that every student in the world just has a fucking laptop in their back pocket and they're just taking it everywhere they go? Hell no, I'm not. This bitch is dead. So I was thinking I would go onto my app store on my phone and maybe find Edgenuity on there so I could do it on the go, right? But they don't have an app. Why the fuck would Edgenuity not have an app? Everybody else has a fucking app. But Edgenuity doesn't have a fucking app. It is so beyond me why they wouldn't have an app on the App Store. Maybe it's because they would get fucking rating bombed. But, I mean, we wouldn't fucking be rating bombing your shit if your fucking system was better, alright? So fix that and then make an app. Or just make an app and get over it. I can't tell you the amount of times I've been thinking in my bed at night, like, damn, I really gotta do my Edgenuity homework, man. But my desktop is in my dad's room, and I don't wanna wake him up. And this piece of shit doesn't fucking work. If only I could have an app on my phone so I could pull up and do my work. But Edgenuity doesn't do that. It doesn't do that, man. Okay, all of this aside, we're finally at the end. The last Edgenuity video, people. Listen, I want to say it right now, though I really do hate Edgenuity, and I can't stand the program, and I really wish that Mr. Beard was my husband. I'm not even gay, but I would be gay for Mr. Beard. I'm just saying that right now. Despite all of that, I still have to owe some sort of thanks to Edgenuity in a way. Listen, before I made the two Edgenuity videos, my YouTube channel was pretty small, I'm not gonna lie. I was barely breaking 100 subscribers. I'll tell you this right now, it has taken me a little over a week to make this video, hence the fucking change of the shirts, right? And in the week that it took for me to make this video, I went from 250 subscribers, I think I'm at 305 right now. So obviously, the Edgenuity videos are getting a lot of traction. You don't really seem to enjoy it, so I'll make you a deal. If this video gets 500 likes, I'll make a follow-up. I'll do it. I'll make a follow-up. It won't be an Edgenuity Experience video, but it will be a follow-up, seeing how Edgenuity has changed, or if they have changed at all. So to Edgenuity, I'm going to let it go now. All right, you're free. You don't have to worry about me anymore. All right? You can take my poster down off the fucking... most wanted list. I'm okay. It's over. That's it. See you.